إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Today إن شاء الله رب العالمين we are going to talk about a subject that to start with I am ashamed of myself even to talk about it. And that is under the title بطانيات إحرامات for للمسلمين في سوريا. Blankets for the Muslims in Syria. You know that things get really miserable and human dignity is lost when the person is not looking for anything but something to cover him so he will not get frozen, not cold. A blanket in the empty land with nothing is available. It's not going to warm you, it's just not just so you will not freeze very quickly. And anyone who suffered from that, he knows what I'm talking about. So this will tell us about something that we have to remember. That when we are short to the Muslims, we are undutiful to the Muslims. At first place, we are undutiful to Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the general rule, and we'll tell you that. Second, wherever we read in the Quran al-Kareem, in the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are going to find that as-sadaqah, charity, is a major pillar. Left, right, up, down, and it is until the Day of Judgment continuous. There is no time to say, well, when it's going to be over, with giving charity, there is no over. When you stop eating, when you stop drinking, when you stop coming to al-masjid, then we'll tell you, there is no need for what? For the sadaqah. And you know, we told you so many times, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when you go to work, your intention has to be to earn for the sadaqah at first place, and to support yourself and your family. This is not something by choice or optional. This is a commandment from Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala and or Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. And I would like you to hear the following, inshallah. Allah says in Surah Al-Hadid, إِنَّ الْمُصَّدِّقِينَ وَالْمُصَّدِّقَاتِ وَأَقْرَضُوا اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا يُضَاعَفُ لَهُمْ وَلَهُمْ أَجْرٌ كَرِيمٌ. Amazing. Indeed, the men who give to charity and women who give to charity and they who have loaned Allah a goodly loan. You are not giving it to anyone. Your charity, you are lending it to who? To Allah al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why you're going to see the verse that said what? مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يُقْرَضُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا. Who is willing to give a loan, a goodly loan, to Allah al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala. It will be multiplied for them and they will have a noble reward. Again, when you are giving the sadaqah, you are not loaning it, you are not lending it to the recipient, the human. You are loaning it, you are lending it to Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, you should not worry, Allah is trustworthy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and this is a question for everyone, من ذا الذي يقرض الله قرضا حسنا فيضاعفه له أضعافا كثيرة والله يقبض ويبسط وإليه ترجعون. Who is it that would loan Allah a goodly loan? Who is it? If your heart is not jumping out of your mouth to say I am, something is wrong. Something is wrong. Yeah? Sahaba al-Kiram, especially at their early days in Al-Madina, they suffered poverty greatly. And we read in Sahih al-Bukhari, Sahih Muslim, everywhere when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to ask for charity, none of them said, well, I don't have. Those who have bare nothing, they used to rush to the market and lend their labor. Anyone wants me to carry something for him? For a full half of wheat, a full half, two hands of wheat, of barley, of dates, and they bring it back to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yeah? Who is it that would loan Allah a goodly loan so he may multiply it for him many times over? Wallahi, nobody does that except a true believer in Allah al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many times over. And it is Allah who withholds and grants abundance. And to him, you will be returned. You're not going to take anything with you, except you. And your deeds. You are, in Al-Quran al-Karim, commanded, as in obligatory, as in wajib, as in fard, as in farz, to lend Allah al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala. Commanded. It's not a matter of option. It is not optional. Look to what Allah al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala says. Inna rabbaka, and you know this is in Surah Al-Muzzammil, and Surah Al-Muzzammil was revealed very, 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 very early in the first few days of the age of Al-Islam. Not a few months, few days. Ya ayyuha al-muzammil. Allah says, Inna rabbaka ya'lamu annaka taqumu adna min thuluthay al-layl wa nisfahu wa thuluthahu wa ta'ifatun min alladhina ma'ak. Wallahu yuqaddiru al-layla wa al-nahar. Alima an lan tuhsuh fataba alaykum. Faqra'u ma tayassara min al-Qur'an. علم أن سيكون منكم مرضى وآخرون يضربون في الأرض يبتغون من فضل الله وآخرون يقاتلون في سبيل الله فاقرأوا ما تيسر منه وأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة. هاي لوحدها خليها على جنب. وأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة. وبعدين في حاجة أخرى. وأقرضوا الله قرضا حسنا. وأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة وأقرضوا الله قرضا حسنا. طيب ليش؟ مين اللي راح يكسب؟ وما تقدموا لأنفسكم من خير تجدوه عند الله هو خيرا وأعظم أجرا صلى الله أكبر واستغفر الله إن الله غفور رحيم. Indeed, your Lord, Allah al-Kareem, knows, O Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that you stand in a prayer almost two-thirds of the night, or half of it, or a third of it. And so do a group of those with you. And Allah determines the extent of the night and the day. He has known long time ago that you, the Muslims, will not be able to do it. That means it used to be obligatory. Qiyam al-layl, tahajjud, during the night was obligatory. Like Salat al-Dhuhr, Salat al-Asr, al-Maghrib, al-Isha. Allah knew you. He has known that you Muslims will not be able to do it and has turned to you in forgiveness. So recite what is easy for you of the Quran. He has known that there will be among you those who are ill and others traveling throughout the land, seeking something of the bounty of Allah, and others fighting for the cause of Allah. So recite what is easy from it, from the Quran al-Kareem, and now pay attention. And establish salah, prayer, and give zakah. And what else? Put this aside. And in the command, and loan Allah a goodly loan. Salah, zakah, and that is not enough. And you must loan Allah a goodly loan, and whatever good you put forward, who's going to benefit from it? It is for yourselves. You will find it with Allah. It is better and greater in reward. And seek, still with all this, and seek forgiveness of Allah. Allah is forgiving and merciful. Next set of verses in Surah Al-Taghabun. Please pay attention how the set of the verses started. Allah says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن من أزواجكم وأولادكم عدوا لكم فاحذروهم. يعني زوجتك تقول لك يا أخي الكريم لا تنسانا. إيش تتصدق إيش تعطي. ولدك يقول يا أخي لا تنسانا. وأنت تقول وين أروح خلي زوجتي وين أروح أخلي ولدي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن من أزواجكم وأولادكم عدوا لكم فاحذروهم وإن تعفوا وتصفحوا وتغفروا فإن الله غفور. إنما أموالكم وأولادكم فتنة والله عنده أجر عظيم. فاتقوا الله ما استطعتم واسمعوا وأطيعوا وأنفقوا خيرا لأنفسكم ومن يوق شح نفسه فأولئك هم المفلحون. ثم ماذا؟ إن تقرضوا الله قرضا حسنا يضاعفه لكم ويغفر لكم والله شكور حليم عالم الغيب والشهادة العزيز الحكيم. O you who have believed, indeed among your wives and children are enemies to you. They come between you and Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially when it comes to spending. I want to save it for my wife. I want to save it for your children. You should save for your wife and your children, but not all. Because if it's saved all for your children, now they are your enemy because they are going to prevent you from the way of Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. To you so be aware of them. But if you pardon and overlook and forgive, then indeed Allah is forgiving and merciful. Your wealth and your children are but a trial, a test. And Allah has with him a great reward. So fear Allah as much as you are able and listen and obey and spend in the way of Allah. It is better for yourselves and whoever is protected from the stinginess of his soul. It is those who will be the successful. Now what? If you loan Allah a goodly loan, He subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply it for you and forgive you. And Allah is most appreciative and forbearing. No word of the unseen, set of the verses ended by, knower of the unseen and the witness, the exalted in might, the wise. You cannot hide anything from Allah Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. Especially your financial ability. Allah does not ask you anything beyond your capacity. So if you can afford a fraction of a penny that you earned from halal and you give it sincerely for the sake of Allah Al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't worry. He's not going to ask you anything. And it's going to be highly appreciated by Allah Al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know the famous hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. سَبَقَ دِرْهَمٌ مِئَةَ أَلْفٍ قَالُوا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَكَيْفَ يَسْبِقُ دِرْهَمٌ مِئَةَ أَلْفٍ ها؟ قَالَ كَانَ لِرَجُلٍ دِرْهَمَيْنِ فَتَصَدَّقَ بِأَحَدِهِمَا وَكَانَ لِرَجُلٍ مَالٌ عَرِيضٌ فَقَالَ مِنْ طَرَفِهِ هَكَذَا فَأَخْرَجَ مِئَةَ أَلْفٍ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, one dirham has out raised out 100,000 dirham. He said, Ya Rasulullah, how it is possible for one dirham to out raise, to out win, to be greater in reward than 100,000? He said, a man used to have two dirhams. Two. Yeah? And he gave one into sadaqah. Translation, half of his wealth. And the other man used to have a vast wealth. And he reached to a side of it and he grabbed 100,000 and gave it into charity. Allah looks to what is in your heart and your affordability. There is no how much. It is what you can afford sincerely for the sake of Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. يا أخوة, we the Muslims who live in this country, worldly wise, we live better than most of the 99.99% of the population of the world. 6 months ago, less than 6 months ago, the statistics says that anyone who makes $30,000 a year, he is among the 1% richest of the world population. $30,000 a year among what? The 1% richest of the world population. We are doing fine. Yeah. Listen to what Allah says. وَمَا لَكُمْ لَا تُنْفِقُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَلِلَّهِ مِيرَاثُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَا يَسْتَوِي مِنْكُمْ مَنْ أَنْفَقَ مِنْ قَبْلِ الْفَتْحِ وَقَاتَلَ أُولَئِكَ أَعْظَمُ دَرَجَةً مِنَ الَّذِينَ أَنْفَقُوا مِنْ بَعْدُ وَقَاتَلُوا وَكُلًّا وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْحُسْنَى وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. One more time, the question. من ذا الذي يقرض الله قرضا حسنا فيضاعفه له وله أجر كريم. And why you do not spend in the cause of Allah? While to Allah belongs the heritage of the heavens and the earth, not equal among you are those who spent before the conquest of Mecca and fought, and those who did so after it. Those are greater in degree than they who spent afterwards and fought, but to all Allah has promised the best reward. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. And Allah, with what you do, is acquainted. He knows everything. Again, the question, who is it that would loan Allah a goodly loan? So he will multiply it for him, and he will have a noble reward. Allah is asking you to lend him. In Sahih Muslim, this amazing hadith, it's in Sahih Bukhari, Sahih Muslim, and others, basically in every book of hadith, but this is the text of Imam Muslim. And we read, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم ينزل الله في السماء الدنيا لشطر الليل نزولا يليق بجلاله سبحانه وتعالى لا يشبه خلقه ولا خلقه يشبهه سبحانه وتعالى ها أو لثلث الليل الآخر فيقول من يدعوني فأستجيب له أو يسألني فأعطيه ثم يبسط يديه تبارك وتعالى يقول من يقرض غير عديم ولا ظلوم من يقرض غير عديم ولا ظلوم سبحانه وتعالى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم فت محمد that is said Allah descends comes down to the lowest heaven at the half of the night or at one third of the latter part Allah descends in a way that fits him as the only God not similar to his creation any way shape form or matter to that matter nor the creation is similar to Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala in any what form or matter way shape Allah is God and we are the creation he does come down how that is we do not know and says who is there to supplicate me so that I answer him Who is there to ask me so that I grant him? Then the blessed, Allah al-Kareem. The blessed and the exalted Lord stretches his hands. And then say, Who will lend to one who is neither needy nor unjust? Neither needy nor unjust. Next, يا أخوة, look to what Allah says and how the verse started. وَلَا يُنْفِقُونَ نَفَقَةً صَغِيرًا وَلَا كَبِيرًا وَلَا يَقْطَعُونَ وَادِيًا إِلَّا كُتِبَ لَهُمْ لِيَجْزِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنَ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ Nor do they spend an expenditure. Starting with what? Small or large? Most of the people, they can afford the small. The very few, they can afford what? The large. But most of the people are the majority. And when they give the little, they will give huge amounts. Nor do they spend an expenditure, small or large, or cross valley, but that it is registered for them that Allah may reward them from the best of what they were doing. Quickly, the famous hadith that all of you are aware of it, then I'll go back to inshallah Rabbil Alameen. Ashhadu himamakum. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Allah azza wa jal yaqul yawm al-qiyama, yabna Adam, مرضت فلم تعدني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم said Allah on the day of judgment will say O child of Adam I have been sick but you have not visited me قال يا ربي كيف أعودك وأنت رب العالمين said يا الله ها My Lord, how it is possible for me to visit you and you are the Lord of all creations. You are God, I'm going to visit God. قال سبحانه وتعالى أما علمت أن عبدي فلانا مرض فلم تعده أما علمت أنك لو عدته لوجدتني عنده Allah would say Have you not known that such and such of my slaves were sick and you did not visit him? If you have visited him, you would have found me next to him. يا ابن آدم استطعمتك فلم تطعمني. O child of Adam, I asked you for food, but you did not feed me. قال يا ربي وكيف أطعمك وأنت رب العالمين. Said the slave, you and I will say, Ya Rab, Ya Allah, how it is possible for me to feed you and you are the Lord of all creation. قال ما علمت أنه استطعمك عبدي فلان فلم تطعمه. Didn't you know that such and such of my slaves asked you for food, but you did not feed him? أما علمت أنك لو أطعمته لوجدت ذلك عندي. Have not you known that if you were to feed him, you will find your feeding with me, with Allah. يا ابن آدم استسقيتك فلم تسقني. O child of Adam, I asked you to feed me some water. قال ربي قال يا ربي كيف أسقيك وأنت رب العالمين. He will say, my Lord, how it is possible for me to feed you some water and you are the Lord of all the creation. قال استسقاك عبدي فلان فلم تسقه. Allah will say, my slave so and so asked you for some water and you did not give it to him. أما إنك لو سقيته وجدت ذلك عندي. If you have provided him with a drink, you would have found it with me. I am feeling very ashamed to ask you, but I have to. When it reached the level that someone comes and tell me we need to raise some money for blankets for the Muslims in Syria, I feel crushed. When people, they ask for that little, and I tell you, especially nowadays, the blankets are not going to keep them warm. Just it is going good to stop it a little from freezing, and freezing to death. So, how many we have? 200 people here? I hope in Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala, thumma, then after that in you, that you do not leave this masjid without giving minimum $10,000 for the blankets, another $10,000 for something else, and another $10,000 for something else. And the greater in reward is the one who starts first. قولوا قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. تبارك الله.